Everyone, I thought I'd share some of my nixie tube designs and include the schematics on my website and the software too. So what this guy is a single tube nixie clock, and it flashes out the time. It goes through like a 12 segment display similar to this one, and it make sure I, all right, flashes this tube, this tube, this tube, this tube in order. So right now it's 138, so 1, 3, 8. And it's all using just a little Atmega 328, a DS1307, 328. And I'm trying to exploit the 2D of the phone, of the camera, so I don't touch something high voltage. DS1307 with its own crystal, and then there's the Atmega 328 crystal right here. The boost converter is all down here. This is the 5 volt linear regulator, and then two inductors. And for this clock, I actually bought the wrong MOSFET. It's oh, what is it? It's VGS threshold is really high. So at 5 volts, it really doesn't conduct much current. Well, if you think about the power, or not power, energy stored in inductor, it's one half. LI squared. Trying to remember that. It's been a while. So what I ended up doing was, since my I is small, I can still get quite a bit of stored energy by increasing my L. So these inductors are just what I had laying around. They're both, I think they're 1 or 10 millihenry inductors, and I've got them in parallel, so that they can handle twice the current, and then the inductance gets halved. Oh, excuse me, it was just whatever I had on hand. And then this diode right here, where's my finger? Here is a high voltage, high speed diode, and that's very critical. So the MOSFET, this guy, has to be high voltage capable, and it has to have a V voltage gate source threshold that's pretty low. And the MOSFET that I used in this design, and the inductor that I used, I'd say if you decide to build this single clock nixie, or the single tube nixie clock, I would say just take this MOSFET and this inductor from this design and just use it as a drop-in replacement. The pinout's compatible, anyway. And then a high voltage capacitor over here. And that capacitor is probably overkill. I think it's, what is it, 68 microfarads. So basically, how it works is the microcontroller has this closed loop time-based interrupt that samples the high voltage line through a voltage divider. So that's closed loop, and I just used a proportional controller because they're simple, easy to tune, and it's not a very picky system. So I've got this high voltage line running up here. There's a current limiting resistor. This goes into the anode of the nixie tube, which is the cage around all the elements. And there's also a right in the middle, down kind of right there. That is a NPN and PNP high side switch. So what that does is it allows me to PWM the anode of the tube, and that's what I do all my PWM from. So I just have one pin for PWM, and then I've got another pin for PWM for the boost converter, and that's got to be a high frequency signal. I think that's running at, I think, the 31 something kilohertz, 32 kilohertz. I don't remember off the top of my head. And I've got FTDI breakout right here, backup battery for the time, DS1307 chip right there. And let's see, and then I can sync each element. So I basically sync the element that I want to turn on, then PWM the high side to make that element light up. Yeah, so I might. Maybe someday I'll make this into a kit, design a PCB. I mainly wanted to copy this design off of a guy who made one very similar called the lethal Nixie clock, Nixie tube clock, because it's lethal. It's got all the wiring exposed, and I had surgery right before. I was like, oh, I want to make this, got all the parts. And then I had a big surgery, and while I was recovering, I made this, and I blame the painkillers as to why it came out so hideous, but it's the design is solid, the electrical design is solid. This thing's about, I don't know, 2 years old, and I run it almost 24/7, so there's sometimes when I unplug it to make space for other devices, other plugs. Anyway, yeah, real simple. The schematic is pretty simple. So if anyone wants to just get started in nixie tubes and make a single tube clock, this would be a good design, and everything's available. So someday in the future, if for whatever reason the Arduino code does not compile, I think I compiled this around version 1 of Arduino. So anything around that time should work, and you might have to downgrade your Arduino if you build this, if you're viewing this video in the far future. Anyway, good luck.